Hi friends, welcome to Gurav YouTube channel. This channel is about education and technological purposes. If you're not subscribed, subscribe to my channel and don't forget to press the bell icon.
Here we will discuss the bubble sort. Sort represent arranging the elements according to the ascending or descending. Here we are sorting the elements by using a bubble sort. Bubble sort represent in a water, if we'll throw any stone, a bubbles comes out, right? Like that, in the bubble sort, the unsorted numbers, in the unsorted numbers, each time a larger number will bubble out and it will be settled down at the bottom. Okay, like that it will work, right? Bubble sort. For the reason bubble sort, we need a how many numbers, that is nothing but n. How many numbers we need for bubble sort? It's a representing for the number n as a 4. Then we have to enter a 4 numbers here. Just I will consider 5, 4, 3, 2. These are the 4 numbers. Are they in ascending order? No, we have to make them as a ascending order. Just I will consider it as a one array which is representing as 0, 1, 2, 3. Just for the convenience, I will use technique. I will tell you in the bubble sort. Consider a present number, compare with the next number. If the present number is greater than the next number, swap those. Swap those represent exchange those. 4, 5, 3, 2. Then the pointer is here, right? Consider the present number compared with the next number. Is it a present number is greater than a next? Yes, then swap. Then 4, 3, 5, 2. Pointer is here. Compare the present number with the next number. 5 is greater than 2? Yes. Then swap it. 4, 3, 2, 5. Clear? If we consider this number, bubble sort represent a larger number will bubble out at each iteration. I will consider it as a 0th iteration. Next I will consider in a 1, 0, 1, 2, like I am considering 4, 3, 2, 5. Is it a sorted number now? No, it is not a sorted. 4, 3, 2. It's a 2, 3, 4, 5, but it is not a complete sorted. Then consider 4, 3, 2, 5. 4, 3, 2, 5. Then take a present number, compare with the next. Swap it. 3, 4, 2, 5. Swap it. 3, 2, 4, 5. We need to swap this 4, 5? No, because present number is less than the next number, so we should not swap it, right? Then is it a complete sorted element? No. Then what we have to do? Again go for the next iteration, then take that 3, 2, 4, 5. Present number is greater than next number? Yes. Then swap it. 2, 3, 4, 5. Now pointer is here. 3 should be swapped to the 4? No, present number is less than the 4, then we should not swap, because at the first iteration one number will be settled as a top, at the second iteration 2 number, at the third iteration 3 number will be bubbled it out and settled at the bottom, then we should not swap again henceforth, right? Then how many iterations need? 0, 1, 2, total 3 iterations we need. For the reason I will consider I is equal to 0, 1, 2, right? 0, 1, total is a 3 iteration we need, right? This I will consider it for the ith value. Jth value, how can we consider jth value? How many comparison has done here? This is a 1 comparison, 2nd, 3rd comparison. Here 3, in here 1, 2, 2 comparison, here 1 comparison. For the jth, 3, 2, 1 comparison happens there. In the sense that when I is a 0, j comparison is a 3. When I is a 1, j comparison is a 2. When I is a 2, j comparison is a 1. Then is there any relationship within I with the n, j with the I and n? Yes, of course. I is related to the n. I starts with a 0. And I is making less than n minus 1. Is it correct? N is a 4. 4 minus 1 is a 3. Right? I is less than 3. Is it not up to 3? I is less than 3. Up to this you are making. Right? less than 3. Less than 3 represent up to 2, you have to make it as a I. Now what about the jth value? J is a 3, which is related with the I and which is related with the n value. N is a 4 here in our example. Then J3 represent 4 minus 1. Can I say? Again, J is a 4 minus 2. Can I say? J is a 4 minus 3. Can I say? Will it give a jth value? No, of course. Here, J is a 3 now when I is a 0. Then 4 minus 1. 4 minus 1 is a 3, of course. Here, 4 minus 2 is a 2 here. 2 comes here. 4 is a n value, right? What about the 2 value? 2 value. 2, can I write this 2 as a like a minus 1 minus 1 minus 1 minus 1. Can I write a 3 as a minus 2 minus 1? Of course, right? Why I am making it as arrangement here, minus 1 minus 0, I will say 4 minus 1 minus 0 represent I value is a 0 here. Again, I value is a 1 here. Again, I value is a 2 here. Then a minus 1 will common here. Minus 1 is a common here. Right. So I will just write it as a J is less than N represent here N minus I minus 1. This is a termination condition for the J. J is started with the 0 and which is doing the operation like this. Then how can we swap this? This is a swap I told you, exchanging. Now how can we swap this? Just I will consider it as a num. Num as a array. Num is a 0 and num and 1 if I will consider, right? Num of a j and num of a j plus 1 if I will consider. It's a j when it is pointing to the 0, j plus 1 represent, it's a 1. Num of j is a 0 here for 5, num of 1 is a 4 here. Then num of j is a 5, num of 1 is a 4 here. Now how can we swap it? To swap, we need a one temporary variable, I will say. Just like a pot here. Just I will give you one example, pot here. It's a num of jth pot, it's a num of j plus 1 pot. We cannot pour one pot to the other pot directly. We need a empty pot here, empty pot like a temp. Then only we can pour, right? What is the procedure from num to the temp we have to store here, right? Then it will become empty. This temp will become here a num j, num of a j, right? This will become a empty. This is filled with the num of j. It's a empty, no? Later you have to, it's the first step. It's a later you have to pour a n num of a j plus 1 to the num of j, right? Then it will become a empty. This will become num of j plus 1. Then this is a empty, no? It's a second step. Then this is a num value you have to store here. This num will become num of j, right? This is a procedure. It's a third. What is the first one? Num of j to the temp. First, it will become empty. Num of j plus 1 to the num of j, it will become empty. From temp to the num of j, right? This is a procedure how we have to do, right? This is some snippet of a code. For I is equal to 0, I is less than n minus 1 I plus plus. For j is equal to 0, j is less than n minus 1 minus I j plus plus. If num of j present a number which is greater than the next number, then swap it. What is that? Num of a j always right to left equal to sign, will assign the value from right to left, right? Then num value is assigned to the temp, right? Num plus 1, j, num j plus 1 is assigned to the j, temp will assign to the this particular thing, right? Which I told in a theory. Now we will see the code of sorting a given n set of elements using a bubble sort. What do you mean by sort? Sort is nothing but arranging numbers either in a ascending order or in a descending order. So arranging the element in a ascending order. Okay. For the reason,
we have declared here num of a 100 length n I j term. Clear the screen here. Here, how many numbers we want? Either we want a 5 number, 6 number, 10 numbers. We have to give that. N represent how many you want, right? Then by using this code, you are reading the values, right? 5, if you are given there as a n as a 5, then 5 numbers you have to enter, right? That will be stored in a num variable. Here you are considered num area as a 100 length, maximum 100 you have to store here, right? This is used to read the array elements. Then this is a code which is used for the sorting purposes, right? This is a code used for the sorting purposes. Now here, what is the code which is used here for the if? This code is used for swapping of the number, changing of the numbers, right? How? If the num of a j, in the sense that first number which is, or say present number, if it is greater than the next number, then you have to change. In the ascending order, larger value should be a bottom, right? If it is a j, is a num j is a larger value which is there in the position of a jth, and j plus 1 if it is greater than, in the sense that jth position number is greater than the j plus 1th position number, then we have to swap here. Then what is the use of this for j is equal to 0 j, which is used to keep the track of each checking number, right? In the sense that each swapping number, it will keep the track. Then what the I will keep the track? I will keep the track how many iterations we need in the sorting of an element, right? For I is equal to 0, I is less than n minus 1. Up to n minus 1 iteration we have to do. In each iteration, how many swapping, or say how many comparison should be done, that will be tracked by j. Then this code will be used to swap the given numbers. Okay, after executing these all, the swapped number is stored in a num variable, num array. Okay, then you have to display that swapped number, right? Sorted number, or say arranged number which is stored in a num. So you have to display by using a for loop. For I is equal to 0, I is less than n, I plus plus. You are printing here num of I, the value which is are the type of percentage DRC integer, get CH, close the main program. Now compile it, run it, enter the number of elements in the array. Just I will consider 5. Then you have to enter 5 numbers. I will enter here 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, right? Now these elements, or say these numbers, or this array of a number which are in the descending order. But bubble sort we designed there, we should give the numbers after the sorting in ascending order. Check here. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. These are in the ascending order which we are getting. Program is executed. Thanks for watching this video. Please like, share, subscribe to this channel, and post your suggestion in the comment box.